Good morning, children. Today we'll learn the important chapter in macroeconomics, that is titled National Income and Related Aggregates. National income, that is, it includes the aggregate value of the final goods. So, national income is the money value of all the final goods and services produced by a country during the period of 1 year. It consists of a collection of different types of goods and services of different types. Since these goods are measured in different physical units, it is not possible to add them together. Therefore, there is no way except to reduce them to a common measure. This common measure is money. And national income is a macroeconomic concept. So, what is macroeconomics? Macroeconomics is that branch of economics which studies economic problems relating to economy as a whole, like level of output and employment. And I have discussed earlier regarding the macroeconomic variables, which are the different macroeconomic variables: income, output and employment, right? So here also it is the economics branch of economic which studies economic problems relating to economy as a whole. And the macroeconomics is derived from macro means, from the Greek word, that is macro means large. Now we'll skip to the goods. I told you about the different types of goods. So what is goods, or what are goods? Goods means are material things which satisfy the human wants. And goods are broadly classified into final goods and intermediary goods. And again, the final goods are classified into consumer goods and capital goods, and the intermediary goods are further classified into used up in the production and the goods meant for resale. So, understand the difference. We'll just consider final goods. What about the final goods? Final goods are those goods which are used either for direct consumption or for investment. Milk and bread are final goods purchased by a household for consumption. But machines and equipments are final goods bought by a firm for capital formation. So that is the difference between in final goods, what about the consumer goods, and what about the capital goods. So consumer goods means the directly for consumption, what all goods directly satisfy for consumption. Capital goods means all types of machines and equipments are final goods brought by a firm for the capital formation. Yes, next we'll discuss about the consumption goods. So the word consumption itself, consumption means for the use. So those goods are those goods that satisfy the wants of consumers directly. For example, television, mobile phones, etc. So you can see the picture here regarding, I told you the consumption goods we have classified again into durable goods, semi-durable goods and non-durable goods. Isn't it? So that these are the different types of consumption goods. And capital goods are those final goods which help in the production of other goods and services. For example, machines, tools and equipments, they are used for the further production of certain commodities. So inventories are also considered a part of capital stock. Inventories means, I told you that inventories that you have studied here in the last year, inventories means stock of the goods are also considered a part of capital stock. So these are the capital goods which helps in the production of the other goods and services. Next, intermediate goods. What about these intermediate goods? Intermediary goods means those goods which are used as raw materials for producing certain commodities. So that is intermediary goods. Then we can see the difference between the final goods and intermediary goods. Final goods means, that is, the goods that are used for consumption or for investment. They are included in national income, they cross the production boundary, and the bread purchased by a household. See the difference between that. And intermediary goods means that are used up in production and goods that are bought for resale. They are not included in national income. They are still in the production boundary. Example, bread purchased by a restaurant. So these are the differences that we have to understand from that. So intermediary goods means that are used up in the production process, and goods that are bought for resale are called intermediate goods. So you can see the images here. That is, a wheat brought by a baker, it is used up. The goods meant for resale, so that are intermediate goods. So that are the differences between the intermediate goods. Intermediate goods are some are for resale. Next, we'll discuss about the stock variables and flow variables. Variables that is measured at a point of time, and flow variables, the variables that is measured during a period of time. For example, let me tell you that is the if we take into account the population, that is the population at a fixed point of time, the population on 17th February 1990. And let me tell you the difference of flow. The population for the year 1990, so it is not a particular fixed point of time, it is a what period of time. Next one is static concept, other one is dynamic concept. As there is no change in the stock variables, it is static one, and flow variables means it is for a certain period of time, so it is dynamic concept. Third difference is not time flexible, because we are measuring at a particular point of time, so no time flexibility is there. Whereas in the flow variables, it is time flexible, because it's over a period of time, so the flexibility is there in time. And examples are given here: the population of India 20 March 2017, and the other one is, that is for a fixed point of time also. Next one we can see about the investment. What about the investment? It refers to the addition to the capital stock of the economy. Gross investment and net investment. Gross means, I told you that word itself, total. So addition made to the capital stock of an economy during a year is called gross investment. So capital stock includes fixed assets and unsold stock. Net investment, that is the actual addition made to the capital stock of an economy during a year, is called net investment. And net investment equals gross investment minus depreciation. So investment refers to addition to the capital stock of the economy. Total addition made to the capital stock of an economy during a year. If you are investing more and more money, what it happens? It will be get added to the existing capital stock of the economy. So the capital stock includes fixed assets and the unsold stock. So what about this unsold stock? That is inventories. So that is net investment. It is actual addition to the investment. Next, depreciation. Net investment means gross investment minus depreciation, I told you. So depreciation refers to fall in the value of the fixed assets as a result of normal wear and tear, the passage of time, or expected obsolescence. That means, as we use more and more machines, after a time period, what happens to such machines? It resulted in the damage in the spare parts of such machines. So it is called in economics as normal wear and tear, passage of time, or expected obsolescence. It is also called the consumption of the fixed capital. So thank you, children, for watching this video.